One of the other tools that can be used with update is a modifier called trace. And trace is often referred to as track backwards. So let's take a quick look at how that functions. I'm going to go ahead and go to Q8. That will take us to that look. And one of the things you'll notice is that my psych levels, 51 through 67, are currently tracking from a previous queue. So maybe halfway through a scene, the director sides, they don't like that shade of blue, and we need to modify it. So we're going to say 51 through 67, and I'm going to bring up my color picker and make those maybe a little bit more steely cyan color. And so the director decides that they like that, and they want to update it for the whole scene. So in order to find out where these fixtures change to blue, I would have to go into blind and navigate around. But the other thing I can do is use a key called trace. So when I hit update, I can hit enter, and that will save these changes to this queue and track them forward. But you'll see on the second page of soft keys, S6 is my trace button. And trace will go and find where the move instructions are that created the track that I'm in and actually modify those. So I'm going to go ahead and hit enter. And now you'll notice that in Q8, those values are actually tracked still. So if we go back and back, you'll notice that those values actually were changed back in Q6. Let's take a quick look at that all in blind. So if we go to channel 51, you'll notice that those changes that we made in Q8 happened in Q6, but they also propagated through to Q9, so they tracked forward. There's another thing that we can do, which allows us to not only track backwards, but to prevent those changes from going forward as well. So I'm going to go back to Q8. And instead of those channels being kind of cyan, let's put them maybe to a little bit more magenta. And I'm going to say update, trace, like I did before. And that will modify my move instructions upstream. But if I want to prevent them from going downstream, I can use what I've been using all along, which is queue only. When I hit enter, that'll take effect. And you can see that Q6 was modified, but those changes did not track through to Q9. Keep in mind that if you're tracing through a queue stack and you encounter a block, the console will add move instructions to that block to preserve the track that you're in, but it won't modify the values above that block.